Well, what's up, everybody? We're back here on Grizzly Mountain again today, and I thought I'd do something just a little bit different this time. We've got all of our equipment moved in into this new job site, which is not far from the sawmill. You can see the sawmill just right back over there. The big bud's still over there with our big pile of trees that we tried to hook up and haul, and this didn't quite work out too well. And you get so many of those trees in there, it's just hard to get them all hooked up. But anyway, so what we're going to do today is, I thought, just for fun, since we're kind of just getting started, I really enjoy doing the fellow bunching, so let's cut down as many trees as we can in the first 30 minutes, and then we'll see how far we get. I want to get all the way over to that road. You can see just to the north of us there is a little dirt road. I want to cut all the way up to there and then hang a right and kind of go down there a little ways, then cut back this way, and we'll kind of define us a little block in there. Well, kind of a rectangular-ish, I guess, squarish block. But anyway, let's see. Nothing else new today. Again, I'm recording episodes ahead of time for this week that you're watching now. It would have been last week for me. Like I said, I got a friend of mine coming into town, so just want to be able to spend some time with him while he's here and not be on the computer. So I'm recording some ahead of time and getting them produced and uploaded and all that. Hopefully, weekend before you see this. So anyway, today is Friday. excuse me. Today is Wednesday, I think. Today is Wednesday, and so I hope everybody's been having a good week, and everything's been going pretty good. So let's see, we're coming up on, well, for me, coming up on about 3 minutes of record time, so I'm going to go ahead and hop in here, get everything fired up just a little bit, get everything started, and let's see. I'm going to try to not talk during this time period and just cut trees. I'll have the sound, hopefully, where you can hear it pretty good. And we'll just see how many we can get cut, so let's get busy. Well, we are off to a good start, shooting trees all over the place. Look at that. I guess I didn't like those two trees. There's so many trees here on this map that are just right next to each other. They obviously didn't use that script that Mirathist has. I should have looked at the tree count before I started all this. Didn't even think about it. Well, I didn't realize that little cabin was there. I guess I see it now on the map. Alright, well, we're not going to go all the way to the road then. Oh, that's it right there. Okay, I just saw a little path. Well, we made it anyway, so... yeah, we'll leave a tree or two for the cabin. So... I guess what I need to do is just... go around... Well, we're kind of blocked off the path here, but I'll go around this tree that's on the ground. We'll leave that non-pine tree, whatever that is. We'll leave that there. And since we've got some trees down, I'm going to kind of go on around those. When we come back for another pass, we'll get the trees that we missed. Let's see. How do I want to do this? I guess we'll just have to start kind of cutting down this little path. And then we'll throw them kind of like this. Some big trees. Oh, it did cut. I thought I missed it. I heard it cut, but didn't see it do anything. I thought I didn't get it. We got it. Yeah, I'm just going to kind of track down this little path and cut everything to the right of it, and then when we get just a little bit ways over, I'm going to cut back to the south, and that'll be our boundary on the east side. Holding up our trees. I guess it's this this couple of trees over here. It doesn't like those big trees. I'm trying to close my grapple on it ahead of time so that way it doesn't, I don't miss the tree. It just kind of, yeah, it doesn't like those trees. Well, we'll come back with a chainsaw or something and get it. I kind of like that those little trees disappear. I like it that it does that, because remember on 17, when I put those little tiny trees on the plantation, it was a nightmare. It looked good, but those things did not disappear whenever you cut them. You had to go around with a chipper and get them up. It's a pain. Alright, about 5 more minutes. Maybe a little longer than that. We started at 3, right? So yeah, we got about 8 more minutes. Well, we've kind of gone past where I thought I was going to cut back. So let's go ahead and make this our cutback point. Get lined up due south, and we'll just try to stay as straight as we can. Always hate cutting back this way because you either gotta swing the trees all the way around to make them accessible, you know, like the butt ends pointed towards the landing for the skidder, or you have to drive all the way back down and make another line back this way. So I think I'll just start putting the trees off to the side like this, where the skidder can just back up and then go straight back towards the landing. See what I'm doing. Didn't help anything. And I know I said let's cut for 30 minutes, and we're coming up on, I think there's about 3 minutes left, but I can see the road right through there, so let's go ahead and try to cut to the road. We're not far away, and then we'll get busy with getting them skidded up and processed and try to get the landing all squared away. Now let's see if this big old tree will cut. At that time, gotta be careful though, because I don't think these big trees aren't, for some reason I think maybe not all the way in the ground or something, so I don't want to cut right. That one doesn't want to cut at all. I have to get the chainsaw out. Let's see, there's our landing right through there. Alright, let me hop out and cut this with the chainsaw real quick. Hopefully it'll fall the right way. Yeah, see, it's, see how high the cut is? That's why the fellow buncher didn't like it. Yeah, I think out of everything that we can do with the forestry stuff on Farming Simulator, I think I like fellow bunching the best. Processing's kind of fun, but I think I like cutting the trees down. It's like you're blazing a path, you know? It's kind of just kind of fun to cut a path through the forest and stack the trees up so you can skid them. Skidding's kind of fun, too. I think, you know, I think if I we're in a position where I had to have a forestry-related job, I think I'd want to be a skidder operator. It'd be kind of fun. I think a loader and a processor are just too much responsibility there. You got to know what you're doing and all that stuff. Make sure the loads are right because the mills were turning the truck around, you know. Just let that one go wherever. All right. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just drive it all up to the landing and park it kind of out of the way. Because as soon as we get a few of these trees skidded up, we'll need to start cutting another swath up through there. Do it now. Let's see here. Our big bud skidder, our skidder overkill. If it just had a blade on the front of it, I tell you, this would be a monster skidder. If it had a blade on the front. I just wish we didn't have to use this silly little extended trailer thing, because it's so hard driving these little small trailers. Let's see, we're at fives. Yeah, I kind of like doing the shorts. Let's stick with the shorts for a while. And we'll try to pile them just as far as we can reach out here. Didn't think I got it. We got all kind of stuff in the way, so I'm just gonna spit the tops right there. We'll pick them up later. Let's get us one more drag of trees brought up, and we'll process those. That's probably about all the time we're going to have for today. Alright, we'll have him ready to go for next time. And try to get some of these stumps ground up to get those out of the way. So let's process these last little bit of trees, and then that'll probably be all the time we have for today. Then what I'll do is, after I finish recording, I'm going to pick up a bunch of these pieces of trees and things and get them chipped up, get them out of the way. It'll help out everything. And then next time when we come back, if I'm not back on Bear Rock, but when we come back here on Grizzly Mountain, I'm going to have the log truck ready to go and we'll get some of this loaded up. I don't want to get too big of a pile here, although the frame rate seems to be doing pretty good. We're sticking right around, well, just about 50. 40 to 50, somewhere in there. That's pretty good. I am running most of my graphic settings on high. So in case you're wondering, that's where I'm at there. I think it looks pretty good. I don't have everything like maxed out or anything. I don't know if my graphics card will handle it, and I just would rather have the better gameplay than super maxed out graphics. Well, that's going to do it for this episode. And like I said, I hope y'all have a good rest of the week, and we'll come back on Friday, and we'll either be on this map again or Bear Rock, not sure which. But anyway, I'm gonna get all this stuff picked up so it's all out of the way and all that good stuff, and try to get some of those stumps ground up. But I'm gonna snap a shot here for our thumbnail, and yep, that's gonna do it. All right. Well, y'all have a good rest of the week. See you on Friday. Have a good one. Thanks for watching.